As far as games programming is concerned, a finite state machine is a simple way to organize our code for our game objects with multiple behaviors. Take for instance in any platformer. Our platformer character is capable of doing a number of things. The character can stand around and do nothing, it can run, it can jump and fall, and maybe even cling to walls. Each of these behaviors can be thought of as a state, with its own unique sequence of code to detect its behavior. As an example, let's illustrate the FSM of a simple platformer character. Let's start with the idle state. We know our player can idle. That means do nothing. The player character can run. Player character can jump. And with jumping, naturally there will be a fall state as well. It is also important to know how each state connects to one another. So let's define the relationship between the states. The character can go from an idle state to a run state should the player press the left or the right button. So we're going to define this arrow here. This arrow we call it an edge. Similarly, run from the run state, we can go back to idle state. And we can go from idle to jump. We can go from run to jump. We can go from jump to fall once you reach the peak of your jump height. We can go from fall back to idle when the character lands on the ground. And there is one more. We can go from jump to run, sorry, run to fall if you were to walk off a ledge. The simplest way to implement an FSM is to just write a series of if statements. However, we are going to go a tiny step further and talk about inner states. Inner states are states within states. As an example, a simple jump state has three inner states. There is the enter state, which runs only once on the first frame of the jump state, the update state, which runs every single frame while the player is in the jump state, and finally the exit state, which runs once when the object switches state. Like for example, from a jump to a fall state. For now, we'll go with the simple implementation that uses a switch statement to make our FSM before we explore other options. It is worth noting that what we will be doing here is just one way of writing an FSM, and is nowhere near being the best way of writing it. It is, however, in my opinion, a great way of showcasing how an FSM works. We shall first proceed by defining the player states. Afterwards, we will define a few variables to keep track of what state the player is currently in, as well as what state the player will eventually switch to. The inner state variable is used to keep track of what inner state you are currently in. So 0 represents the enter state, 1 represents the update state, and 2 represents the exit state. I will also write a helper function for allowing us to switch to a different state easier. There we have it. This will be the code that is written in the create event of our player object. At this point, we will have the variables we need to start writing the FSM for the player character. So our goal now is to make this character move around. We will begin by going to the step event and start implementing our FSM using a switch statement. Here we have our idle state. Now this is an empty state, and the idea is that we are supposed to write the logic within this particular case to make the player switch to an idle animation. Likewise, we will need three other states. We now have all the four states within the switch statement, and we need to start writing the code to make the character move about. Within the idle state, we need to switch the player's animation to the idle animation in the enter inner state. And then we need to define the transition from the idle state to the run state. So the transition happens when the player were to press on either the left or the right key. Here we define the transition to the run state. Likewise, we will need to do the transition from the run state to the idle state within the run state itself. But before that, let's write the logic to move the character within the run state. You can see that we can now move left and right, and if I were to let go of the movement key, we will switch back to the idle state. So what we need to do now is to simply implement the rest of the states, like the jumping and the falling. Well, it looks like we have all of the four states implemented. Right, we can go from idle to jump, we can go from jump to fall, we can go from fall back to an idle state. We can even go from a running state to a falling state if we were to walk off this platform here. So we have the entire transition implemented as depicted in this diagram. Now there are quite a lot of copy and pasting in this particular implementation of the FSM, so this can be improved by perhaps writing certain helper functions, right, in order to reduce the duplication of code. Now suppose we want to play a jumping sound effects when the player character jumps, where will we be placing the line of code in the finite state machine? Naturally, the line of code would be in the jumping state, but there are three inner states within the jumping state. There is the enter state, there is the update state, and then there's the exit state. So given the fact that we only want to play the jumping sound effect once, right, on the first frame where the player character jumps, we would need to place that line of code in the enter state. You can see that it works as intended. Using a switch statement to implement our FSM is decent enough if there are not many states to manage. But, as can be expected, this approach is not necessarily scalable and the code can quickly become hard to manage. Instead of using a massive switch statement, we could consider implementing the states as functions and have a struct manage those functions. But, let's leave the details for another time. That is it for this tutorial. I hope this is useful. This sample project can be downloaded from the descriptions below. Also, please consider liking the video and subscribing to my channel, and perhaps even check out my games. That would be super awesome. Thank you, and I'll see you very soon.